Hi everybody, this is Jordan Davis again. Thank you for clicking on this video and welcome back to my channel once again. If you don't know who I am, and I'm assuming that most of you probably don't, I'm a graduate student at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill in the Department of Anthropology, But outside of my graduate studies, I'm really big into the Eurovision Song Contest. And so this year I wanted to start doing some reactions just because I think being an American Eurovision fan, there aren't many people to talk with these things about casually. And so why not bring it to the forum of the internet? So today I'm gonna be reacting to another entry that has already been released. I'm gonna be reacting to Belgium's entry for this year, Hooverphonic with the song Release Me. I'm really excited for this song, especially given that I really liked Belgium's entry from 2 years ago, Cynic, with Matter of Time. Last year, I liked Belgium's entry like as a song, and I listened to it occasionally now even, but for a Eurovision song, it wasn't my favorite. And so I wasn't too surprised when it didn't qualify, especially given the staging from last year. But we'll see what this song is like. Hopefully, it'll bring something to the table that Belgium didn't bring for the past couple of years, because they haven't qualified for the past couple of years. So hoping they get back in the game with this, but let us see. Okay, so this is another kind of slow, slow, moody song. Only you can make them go away, yeah, release me. I like the melody of the song though. From the sudden losing game. Release. Okay. So Belgium is kind of continuing with the trend that they've had for the past 4 years now. Sending these slow, very deeply moody, dark tracks. I like these tracks as tracks, but they require a lot in the way of staging, because we kind of know how Eurovision works, right? And songs like this, while they may be good songs in general, on a Eurovision stage, they don't bring too much in and of themselves, so it requires a little bit of staging work. But I like this song. Like, I will download this song when it releases. I actually really like this. Like, it's a catchy little song, and I like the atmosphere. I like in the video the strings, all of the various types of strings that they have. And her voice is really smooth in this track. Like, her voice is a fantastic match for a track like this. Like, I could imagine just on a rainy night, lighting a couple of candles and like dancing around the room just by myself. Just dancing around the room, slow dancing by myself, just in my feelings. I could imagine that. This seems like this kind of a song when you're not necessarily in the best mood, or just when you want to put yourself in a more somber place. I don't like her dress. That's one thing I don't like. It's not great, but I like the song though. I mean, the dress, it can be changed. That's easy to change. But this song, I really am jiving with the song. Like, it's not my favorite this year, but I'm jiving with it. I think that was good. That was good for me. I've heard a lot of people talking about how they don't like it, and I totally see where people are coming from. thinking that they don't like it, or not thinking that they don't like it, expressing that they don't like it. It's definitely not for everyone, and especially in the context of Eurovision, given Belgium's track record for the past couple of years, and given that even the year that they did qualify last, they sent a song that was kind of dark in a similar way. I can see how this is kind of getting routine for Belgium, and for the past 2 years, it hasn't worked. So routine in a negative way, perhaps. But I really am jiving with this track. I hope they do something with it that will allow them to get back into the final. Because I like Belgium. I like what Belgium sends a lot of the time. And I think this song would deserve to be in the final if it gets to the final, if you know what I mean. Like, the song is good enough that if it gets to the final, I think it would deserve to be there, especially if they up the staging. But it's also one of those tracks where if it doesn't get to the final, I could see why it doesn't. So it's really a borderline for me at this point. I like the track. Again, I'm going to download the track personally because I like it. I like the vibe of it. But I'll be able to understand why whatever happens, happens regardless. It won't be a shock non-qualifier or a shock qualifier for me. So those are my thoughts on that. If you like this video, then please feel free to like the video. If you want to comment, please comment, because I love to engage with people about these things, whether it's an agreement, a disagreement, or just a discussion about something else totally. And if you have any other songs that you want me to react to, please feel free to comment those, and I definitely will. I'm just kind of shooting shots in the dark right now as far as the songs I react to. There are a couple of songs that I really don't want to react to just because I know I don't love them already. And you know, I'm trying not to be negative, because for the most part, I love Eurovision so much that I love 99% of the songs. Especially after the contest is over for a given year, then I really start to listen to even the songs that I didn't like initially. So, but this early on, I hate being negative and saying that I don't like songs, but there are a couple of songs that are definitely not for me. So I'm trying not to react to those ones, but I might anyway. We'll see what happens. But if you have any that you'd like me to react to specifically, please let me know. Again, please comment, please like the video. But other than that, have a great day. Thank you again for watching, and we'll see you next time.